Well, this was a bit of interesting news, and I think that maybe it makes a lot of sense that Sony's going to do this. Simply put, they can't be in the same situation that they found themselves in previous generations with no games at launch for their next console. So if you look back to the PlayStation 4, it launched with Knack and Killzone Shadowfall. Not exactly the best launch lineup you could imagine. And then when you go back to the PS3, I think it launched with like Resistance, maybe another game or so, but it was nothing really amazing. It wasn't until later on that people started getting games and Sony started putting out some amazing games, and they did. To be fair, the PS3 had some amazing exclusives, especially towards the end of the generation. And I gotta say, the PS4 did the same thing. You know, I think underappreciated the amount of work and the amount of effort and the amount of dedication that Sony puts out with their consoles for their fans, and the fact that they continually deliver. I think I'm starting to appreciate that a little bit more now, and I think that it's gonna be funny to see how that continues to play out. But this in particular seems to confirm from Sony themselves what they've got up their sleeves, and I think you guys are gonna like it. Hey, what's up, everybody? Crap Gamer here with Crap Gamer Reviews, back with another video. Thank you guys for checking it out. I really do appreciate it. Like, share, subscribe. Please hit that bell if you want to get notified of all the content as soon as it drops. I would really appreciate that as well. It's one of those things where I'm very excited by the next-gen hardware. I I've been saying for a long time, I'm very excited by what appears to be Sony's VR, focus for next-gen, wireless headset and things like that on a very powerful box. Means we're going to get extremely powerful and good VR, and that's very exciting. But this isn't really about VR. This is about something else. Sony, it looks like, are pushing back some of their exclusives to better prepare for next generation and having cross-gen exclusives as well. And this comes by way of a leak, which I will link as well, so you guys can check this out. And I gotta say, I am on board with this because it makes it look like stuff like The Last of Us 2 and like Ghost of Tsushima and Death Stranding are going to be PlayStation 5 titles as well, which I find that to be very smart because it's going to allow people to jump right into some fantastic lineup as well. And as well as Sony has a new studio working on a new game that should be able to actually get out there and produce some quality content for people. So I think that's going to be cool, and I think that Sony fans are going to be excited about it. As for Xbox, I believe Xbox is going to launch with some fantastic games as well. We don't really know exactly what. Sony tends to let people know what's coming well in advance, so I'm sure we'll hear that soon enough. But Microsoft, on the other hand, not exactly big on the whole, you know, sharing information on games. We'll hear about new consoles and hardware all day long, but when it comes to games that are coming even like a year and a half down the road, we never hear much. So looking forward to seeing what both these consoles can bring down the road. I'm looking forward to it anyway. I don't know if you guys are, but if you are, let me know. Sound off, rate, comment, subscribe. Once again, thank you so much for watching. Rack 'em up. Crap Gamer out.